I am in Missouri. What's the name of this little town?
Bourbon, Missouri.
Bourbon, Missouri. I am in the secret lab of Sky Huddleston, proprietor of the Liberator stove. And you might recognize these. These are the Liberator Mach 1s. That we've been showing people at the Mother Earth News Fair.
These are partially completed.
Partially completed. This is a rocket heater that's UL listed so that the friendly insurance folks and the friendly code government folks
don't cry.
So they think that it's safe. So so they'll let you put it in the house. This is a cute little new one. This is a mini rocket heater that work with it. It's got a great pellet hopper here. It uses the same pellet hopper as the Mach 2 Liberator rocket.
This is the RMH 2.0. This model is going to be the one that gets approved.
So a pellet stove that is doesn't use any electricity and will be EPA approved and UL listed like its predecessor, the Mach 1 of the Liberator over there.
Mach 1 is only tested to UL standards. The Mach 1 is not EPA approved. This one will be.
So this one will be EPA approved. It's going through that right now. Yep. It's got the external air feeds built in so that it can be installed in a mobile home like mine. It's got this burner here for pellets that slides in so you can use either pellets or scrap wood like I use. I heat my house with something like this that I built myself for before I met Sky for about $100 a year in scrap cutoffs from a flooring manufacturer down the street from me. And the Mach 2 has, we can see one of these over here, a ceramic coating on the inside of the metal so that it can get hot enough to be a real rocket heater, which is pretty cool.
So I just took off that longer pellet feed tube, and with just a shorter pellet feed tube, which I don't have on hand, so the even the mini camp heaters are going to use the same type and kind of pellet hopper that the larger ones do, so you can get a 16 to 20 hour burn out of this tiny little heater.
16 to 20 hour burn, no electricity.
And it's got a little shutoff valve right there to shut off your pellet flow.
Shutoff valve. That's pretty slick. I feel like an infomercial, but I think it's really cool to be able to come out here in the middle of nowhere. It's really not middle of nowhere. You're less than an hour from St. Louis,
yeah.
But it just feels like the middle of nowhere, which is nice. It's like my house. Yeah. So this is look. I love this. This is a big over here in the corner. This 4 foot by 4 foot plasma cutter CNC router to cut all these pieces so nicely.
Uh-huh.
This is production, and the rocketheaters.com.
Yep,
rocketheater.com, and if you tell them Uncle Mud sent you, they'll give you $100 off.
I will.
Yeah, and I think it's really cool to find out where this stuff happens.
Happens in American garages.
American garage, not Walmart. Not the other side of the world. America.
America.
America. Only this is people in America actually doing stuff for ourselves.
Yeah,
but this is a really cool. This is a really cool setup. So, and this will have the ceramic coating on the inside of it. Well, that one already does because it's welded together. So.
Yep, this one does. Right now, it doesn't look like it's coated. If you just take your finger, you'll notice with the flashlight, you can actually see these little white speckles.
Yeah.
That's your coating. You can just barely see through. But like I was saying earlier, it turns black after, and that's basically how it appears. It turns black.
Yeah, because it absorbs the carbon from the, instead of flying off, it's actually absorbing more protective coating from the wood that you're burning.
So the zirconia oxide ceramic is porous. And the carbon through the combustion products and from the surface of the steel gets absorbed into the matrix of the zirconia coating. And when it's in this zirconia oxide matrix, the carbon can't really bond with the oxygen in that environment. And so now it's no longer porous. Now it's a combination of zirconia and carbon. And carbon, in the absence of oxygen, is like over 4,000 degrees. This is max temperature rating. So it's a really, really thin refractory ceramic coating is what it is.
Well, I'm looking forward to firing one up because people are smarter than me are going to have to figure out what you just said. But this is really cool. Well, this is Uncle Mud coming to you from Missouri. I'm on my way to the Mother Earth News Fair in Topeka, Kansas, where we're going to fire up this little jobby. This is going to be fun. So this is a camp stove version of the rocket heater with the ceramic lined core and the ability to have an outdoor air feed and pellet hopper.
Yeah, if you look down there, you can actually see, well, we've been testing. You can see maybe that white, blackish ceramic.
Yep.
So, yeah.
And this is excellent. Oh, yeah, yeah.
So this is the ceramic
core on the inside of the door. It's already starting to absorb
the carbon. But you'll notice that you could tell that the ceramic didn't flake off.
Right.
You just rang your finger across it. You felt no difference or height or anything, right?
Nope, it's the same stuff, yes. Well, thank you, Sky, for sharing your afternoon with us. This is really great to see how much you guys have gotten accomplished in the last year since I was here.